Okay, getting ready to go. We've got 338. Just maximize that one there. Go, I'm assuming we're on the track. There we go.
Right. All set, I think. Daisy's had some biscuits. Just say hello to it in. Right, so get our triple going, see if we can.
The session today, I think, is 6 by 2 minutes 30 at 3k pace, so I'll do those about 16 and a half, I'd say. Probably got a minute. Need to go. Facebook gang. Only got a minute. Show to the group. Okay, have a good run. Yes, thanks, James. 30 seconds to go. Careful watching what we actually do in this one. Hopefully Mike has got the beacon this week. Right, I'll be off. There we go. So what do? We start in the track here and go immediately to the right. Yeah, then we're off the track, aren't we? It's right on field, I think. So, what speed are we doing? I'm with Stephen again. That's windmill. Right, nice and easy to start with. Get quite so nervous with this one because you can't see what's coming up. About 6 by 2.5 minutes. So that'll be like, not quite an 800 for me these days. That is Krista. So he's probably going a bit quicker than me. So I did the same sort I did the other day. Are we on stage 7 already? I've missed 2 stages actually, so I'm going to have to do them again when they come around after my marathon, hopefully. Or will they come straight next week? Not sure how it works. Thirty seconds pick up at 5 minutes. So I've got 2 minutes to go. I'm too used to these runs by time as well, they're coming in. If you feel good, great. Let's say in 20 minutes. Back down. So what speed shall I do? I'm doing something like great almost. I'm just tired for my weekend. So I tried to say I'll try the first one at 16.5, see how I feel. Get a spring in the legs. Right, another minute of easy running. One more minute to count and then we start. So doing 2.5 minutes. 6 minute mile pace would be 3 minutes for half a mile. So it's a bit less than two laps, maybe 700 metres maybe. See how we go. Where is that coming past me? I'm still there in the route working. Right, we need to go 8 minutes for 2.5, so until 10:30. Let's try this first one at 16.5. 16.6 was that one. Advantage of this recovery is that you can do whatever you like. I need to really catch up with somebody. I'll keep up somewhere. Alright, we're like 20 seconds off again. Let's see if we can measure that point one each time. So, 16.7, that's a try for. 16.7. Until 14.30. Chris and Ricky's doing it. Right, so that was 16.7, 16.6, 16.7, and now we've got 16.8. Okay, we're done. So, three down, three to go. We're doing this 16.9, aren't we, for the ramp up. Sure, we're off again. Right, 16.9 then. Okay. Pull down. Is it 24 yet? Be the 17 on here. Is it 24 or 24 first? Here we go. What's the 24s? Surely last 2 800 meter pace. You're joking. It's an 800 meter rip. we'll go 17 then. Right, one more. There's only one more minute. Put these ones, you go faster, you don't get it easier, do you? You still got 12 minutes. Right, last one. Just going to see what speed recovery's do. So Stephen's doing a lot quicker recovery pace than me, which means he might just catch me up in a sec. No, not quite. Right. What speed should we try for here? 17 and a half. Up here, but That's training. A few more than required, but I always like to get a bit of work in quicker than marathon pace. I like to see them quicker than 5k pace. That last one. Right, so we've got another 3 minutes of jogging in the actual group run. Let's get this heart rate down a bit. So I started at 16.6 and then ended at 17.5. Let's just warm into that a bit. That was alright. Kind of needed these recoveries though. So working hard. Well, I was, now I'm jogging. Let's get this heart rate down a bit more. There's our second K. 426. So we're actually running hard for, well, just under 800, wasn't it? About another 700, I guess. So should I run to 10k? I don't know if we really. What I ought to do now is try and work out whether my run is actually working properly. I've got a cold coming on, so I didn't feel really well after this. I felt alright in it as I got going. I think I'm just really tired. Yeah, I suppose the guided run's nice because it's a bit of a novelty, but you are ending up running on your own and you're relying on someone like Mike to guide you, because when you're doing those intervals, well, for me, I'm doing them pretty hard, so you sort of, your brain's not really able to concentrate that well on when I'm going to start again, all this sort of stuff. So someone having you telling you start at 24 minutes, finish at 26.30 several times in the rep is kind of essential, otherwise you end up sort of thinking, how much further have I got to run? Well, you think that anyway, because it's not hard work, but... Well, I'll take this up to 10k when you finish the rip run. Where's the arch? Think about time once, there's no barrier, is there? You just finish wherever you are. 4 seconds. Let's go past this guy, then we'll go back to the normal world, I guess. So yeah, 24.50 in the first 25 minute run, so a bit of running. I know that was the little bit from the start to the track, and that. Alright, so 2.5k to run. Just let's just back up to a more steady pace. It's nice to get a bit of a warm down after a hard intervals. It's a bit of temptation for everyone to potentially start off a bit too easy, because you don't really get that sort of fully loose feeling, I find, with just a mile jog and a one stride. That's okay. Great to finish. Really could have gone a bit faster earlier on than having to notch it down, which I've had to do a few times in the past. Yeah, marathon training sort of has been a bit wobbly, to say. But I had a really good weekend. I did 10 miles at marathon pace on Saturday, then a long 22 mile on Sunday. I was just almost a bit of a final test to see whether I was fit enough. And the long run was a real slog because it was so wet. And I tend to get quite a lot of water puddles and stuff, so yeah, it was a tricky one. So now I can do one more week of normal training and then we start to look to ease off a bit next week, and then the race is the week after that, so I've only got 2.5 weeks to go. Scary stuff. Looks like Stephen's finished running. So we'll do another 10 minutes, you see. Let's go for 12.1. So I'm not searching the bag, but it will be one of them these last 2k. I haven't done a huge amount of running this week. Did a tour event on Monday. Started slowly, then Christopher and Stephen came up from behind very quickly, so I then sort of found myself actually racing them. And then yesterday I did a very weary 10k. So a bit worried I wouldn't go too far well today. But I got through that right. Some days you just need to have the incentive to go along quicker. What's the guy doing? Some free place here. Eh? Watch out, it doesn't even go that quickly. So it keeps it up. Right, so another just over a mile to go. So anyway, thinking K, it just seems a lot longer. And then you think in miles, you haven't really done so much, so I can't really win either way. What I ought to try and do is see if I can measure my treadmill. That now rather than much running. Just slow down momentarily. Get my camera out. the fifth. For some reason, you can't set the GoPro. The GoPro time seems to lose its time. Very good damage. So. It's the Beale Marathon, Mark, if you're still watching. I'm just trying to get my run up to 12 miles an hour so I can see what speed. Right, it's 12 kph exactly. I'm going to record this my treadmill. Me running at 12k. See if I can actually work out with a bit of mass how fast my treadmill is actually going. Compare it to what this stride and the run record I'm getting at. So we'll just run out this next mile. Run as a riders. sure. I went from Denmark. Well, what I need to try and do is have maybe a few of them goes a different speed. See if I can detect that as well. Right, so I'm going on 5k, 5 minutes per k pace. Let's do an experiment on wall down. Thanks for having us see you back here at Zwift HQ. It's new in Tennington, moving to the States. Right, let's keep going until 9k. If we do a quarter of a k each, going up 0.5, so too hard without, be too hard without them, so get some data. Right, 12 and a half, 4.25. Audio is still going sub-3 pace. Is he running continuously? That's ridiculous. So excited, isn't it? Oh, here he comes. Oh no, he's slowed down now. Right, I'm going to change speed to go 13, I think, for the 250. Okay. who's the sniffing? A cold one, right? Right, what we'll do, I think, is we'll go 14k into 0.75 and then finish at 15. That's a different later. So one more lap of the track we're getting. finished this, I've got 15. That is going to be visible on my video. A bit dark in here, isn't it? Let's just take it round to the next lap. Alright, yeah, let's go 10-5 now, all the way here. Okay, done. Stop all the watches. Okay, so we've just been recording my treadmill with this with the GoPro on slow motion. See if I can actually capture what the belt speed is doing from this video. See if we can compare it to the run. The run seems to be measuring slightly faster than what the treadmill says, but the stride is actually coming up a lot slower than both of them. So even with the calibration of 102.5% that I use outdoors, I think the stride I worked out would need a calibration around about 106.0% to work. So we need to see if we can get any footage from this and work out what speed's going on. So I did a run there where I did sort of 250 meter intervals, 0.25, but I think I did 12.5, 13K, 14K, 15K, then back to a steady 10K. So hopefully I'll be able to pick those pits out from the video and see what we can see later on. Okay, bye. Right, so all good. Let's have a look at the session stats now. Camera off. Right, in run. So the fastest K there was 4:14. Probably the fastest 800 and 8:259. Fastest 400 is probably more telling because that was the intervals were probably worked out about 700 meters, I think. So 1:22. That must be on the last one. So 1:22 doubled up to a 2:44. Yeah, that probably was my 3K pace. Maybe even a bit quicker. It's always going to be different, a bit different outside, but yeah, it wasn't too bad. Right, in run. What are we seeing here? Timeline. So, yeah, alright. What did the cadence do? Got to 153 heart rate. So we were, I think it was 16.6, 16.7, 16.8, 16.9, 17.2, 17.5, and then a bit of steady stuff, and I did 12, 12.5, 13, 14, 15, then 10. That was the bit where I was recording it on the with the GoPro. Alright, cadence. Just take off the other bits. So cadence on the fastest bit got to mid 180s, and then started off just low 180s. Yeah, so low to mid 180s on those, and then creeping up to about 180 on the 15k bit. Right, this all looks good. Those back, here comes Daisy. Daisy! Daisy! How are you? You're saying hello? Or do you want biscuits?
Do you want the biscuits or you can say hello? You've got to say hello first, Daisy.
Say hello. Hello. Come on then, do you want some biscuits? Light off. Okay, so back to the run here. Okay.
Okay. So I've got a bit of a sore throat.
But, right, that's the end of that. How long have I been
streaming for? 1 hour, 5 minutes.
That'll do us, I think.
Let's go back, turn off the stream. Okay, see you on the next one, probably next Monday, unless I just answering a few of these messages. That's it, I think. Right, so that's the end of the video. No one's watching, are they? See you later. Bye. Thank you.
instructions, and we're going to follow. So we're picking it up a bit quicker. So a couple more minutes of easy running, says Mike. Attention to the instructions.